left the dock. And as soon as we left the dock, we suddenly got swarmed by horse flies. I mean, there's 100 of them in here. Wave's doing a good job of killing them. He's a cheap horse fly killer right now. He's got
the horse fly.
He said enough to make a pie.
Yeah. Horse fly whisperer.
Yeah, he's got enough to make a pie. But they're just everywhere. So we're motoring out of the inlet right now. Derek's with us up there. You killing any horse flies too?
I got about 10 under my belt.
All right, man, that's good. William's trying to get enough for a pie.
Thanks, so. Good eat.
So it's about 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and heading offshore. We got, I think, about 24 baits rigged and another 20 baits ready to roll. So we're gonna hit the Gulf Stream in the morning. Hopefully catch a lot of fish. Oh, there. Yep, another one. All right, we're just now getting out of the inlet, straight out of the gate. And what do we got? Really big storm hit right our way. That was going offshore, but at a relatively low pace, and it's also coming up from the north, so I think we're going to gate. Unfortunately, the wind's right on our nose as well, but that's not so bad. See that squall line, and we don't want to have to pull sail up and get approached by that, but that could easily have some 30 knots or more. So, let's see what we can go on. Right out of the inlet, too, so. We'll see how this goes. We could go in the inlet, of course, and anchor up, wait it out. That would be a smart thing to do. But I think we can bust through it fairly quickly, I hope, and come out on the other side of it. Be okay. Might mess up our dinner plan. Okay. Oh, I saw some rays jumping out of the water right here. That was pretty cool. Maybe we'll catch another one. Like I said, right out of the gate, as soon as we leave the inlet, we're not even in the sea buoy yet. What do we got? Ah, jeez. Oh, yeah. That's got 30 knots of wind in it. Yeah, we're seeing 30 knots of wind, and it got quite cool, quite fast.
I like it.
Oh, man.
I like it. Fly killer.
Yeah. Yeah, 30 knots so far.
Wicked looking over there. Check that out.
All right, I think we're going to have to put our windshield down here. All right, well, we got through the storm and skated on the very edge of it, a few lightning bolts. At one time, the Ray Marine went out on us, but it basically rebooted itself. And we don't have a lot of wind, but we're getting a little bit of wind on it. And look at that. That's pretty beautiful. Yeah, we got this nice view right before we start grilling dinner. Should be able to grill dinner. Good morning, everyone. It is about 4:45 a.m. We have been motoring most all of the night, and we are only about 4 miles from our initial waypoint that we put in, which is in about 180 feet of water, and shortly after that, you're quickly into 300, 600 feet of water. That should be prime fishing ground. I am on the early morning watch right here, looking for the sun to come up this morning. Sorry about that squeaking that you hear. That is the sail. We have roughly 9-10 knots of wind. It is coming from the beam. But all of my mates are asleep right now, so I'm not going to put out the jenny yet. And I'm almost at my waypoint anyway. I want to sort of be there at sunrise, and then I'll put out the fishing lines at that time. So I'm not in a big hurry. So a little little bit of lightning off on the distance here, but I think that's well north of us and moving north. So I think we're gonna have really a lovely day. A little bit of bump, some wave action here on the bow, but I think we'll be turning north once we get to our wave point, following the Gulf Stream up, and that should give us a pretty comfortable ride. I might end up sailing just on the Jenny, because if I'm on the Jenny and we do catch a big fish, it's much easier to get that sail in quickly to be able to catch the fish. So, today's the fishing day, all right? Let's see what we catch.
All right, the biggest fish of the day. Here we go. What we got, brother?
Woo-hoo! Look at this thing.
Let me see that fish. Oh, yeah.
It's a beauty.
Yeah, look at those colors.
Do me a favor, can you snap a photo on that?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
All right, don't let him get off of the boat. Biggest fish of the day. Woohoo!
Right.
Hold on to him. He's too heavy.
He's fucking heavy as shit.
All right, we probably ought to put him in the box.
Yeah.
Y'all want to do that?
Yeah.
All right, so you got to put him in there and sit on that. You got to get his head in, his tail will stick out.
Should we knife him again?
Well, his brain's so small, you can try. It's right behind you.
Whoa.
That's fucking the knife's right behind you.
All right, I'll just
go
throw him.
Yeah, grab that throat latch. You're going to have it.
Grab the tail?
You'll get his head in the box, but that'll be about it.
Alright. And
sit down. Somebody sit down.
Sit on.
Don't have a choice but to do it like that. Ah!
That's a beast. Oh, shit. That thing is awesome. Thanks.
There's the biggest fish of the day. Got another one on now. What you got, William?
Right, turn. Okay.
What you got?
Like,
yeah, he's a big one. Oh, yeah. Go ahead, forward. Go ahead, forward. Go. Oh, shake it.
I got him fully hooked.
You got him going in there. Get the fish straight to the cooler.
I got him. I got him.
I'd help you, but I'm busy.
Go. We got room in the cooler? I think we got room in the cooler. It's a little bleed out.
We're gonna make room. I gotta play him too, I guess.
As the sun of the sun of the sea, I went out to sea for
the well, we're becalmed now, and we wanted to have some lunch, so we just stopped, turned the motors off, and drifted. It is, you see big rollers in the background, but really slick, no wind per se. But we were afraid if we put another bait in the water, we'd catch another fish, and we'd be cleaning, filleting, catching fish. So we're taking a break to have lunch. Really nice, though. These big rollers are cool. I mean, those things have got to be 8 feet, 10 feet.
Look at that.
Yeah. And there's been really great current lines, eddies, tons of bait around, and really big dolphins, big mahis. So it's been great. And now we're going to, unfortunate, wait for dawn, have some potato chips for lunch, right? And Bronson hot dogs.
Looks like they're putting out any effort.
Oh, wow. Look at that. I think we're like a mothership or something. Coming right off the shore, and that was going to hit us right in the middle of the inlet, so we decided not to navigate that tonight. And just now dropped the anchor. So we're going to kind of wait out this storm right here. Oh yeah, you can see the lightning out there, and the, I don't know if y'all can see it. Ocean's okay when we're out here in the ocean. No big swells or anything, so we'll wait it out here and maybe get some sleep.
Hey, Steven, what you got there?
So we went fishing. We got some mahi. That's the main thing that we caught out there, lots of them. So we've already taken out the majority of the fish.
How many are in there?
We caught at least a dozen. There were some 60-pounders.
Oh my gosh.
Really, really great, big, beautiful mahi. So we got plenty of them, plenty to eat. So now we're in the process, of course, of finishing off the fillet. There were so many of them when we were offshore, I couldn't keep them in the cooler. They were too big. So I had to fillet them while I was out there offshore. So it was a matter of catching, filleting, put them in the box. I did the best fillet job as I could while I was out there. Finishing up that fillet job right now, get the skin off of them. We're going to clean them up, package them up, and freeze them in the freezer.
Okay. And we've already given some away to people that were on the boat as well, and we might give some to our dock neighbors. We just arrived back in Bohicket Marina, so, you know, we got to bring gifts.
That's right. And a gift of fish is a good gift to have.
Sure is.
Guess what time it is? It's time to finish cleaning the fish and put them in bags and freeze a lot of them. We're gonna give a couple to friends, but we're gonna have to freeze a lot of it because there's there's, I don't know how many pounds of meat here. There's a lot. So first step we're going to do is get the raw cleaned fish in from Steven and wash it off and make sure that there's no yucky stuff on it. You certainly don't want to freeze it with all that stuff in there. And then I let it drain and make sure that it's as dry as it can be, because you don't want to freeze it with a lot of water in it, because it'll get iced up and that doesn't taste as good. So as dry as you can. And then I'll do any last minute trimming if there's any bloodlines still on it, like this here. I want to cut that out and try and make nice fillets as much as I can. And then I put it in the bag. Whatever serving you're usually used to having, so usually it's just Steven and I, so I put enough for us and a little leftovers. And this vacuum sealer works awesome. Better than Ziplocs, because it really seals them. This is a super old one, but still works great. Sucked all the air out and sealed the bag, and it's ready to go in the freezer.
And here is our freezer full of fish.